Coming up, a quick little way to help you deal with worry. Hey everybody, it's Harry Kalymnios here from thethoughtgym.com, here helping you become the best leader you can possibly be, giving you all the tools that you need to think, feel and be superhuman. Happy Mother's Day, if it's Mother's Day where you are, if you're watching this the day it's released, it's Mother's Day here in the UK. So quick shout out to all the mothers out there, if you're a mother, have a mother, once knew a mother, whatever it might be, quick happy Mother's Day to you. Happy Mother's Day especially to my mum, who is my number one fan, watches all my videos and helps me grow as a person by giving me great feedback that I can take my performances and my speeches and everything else to another level. So thank you mum for that, and for you watching, if you're ever in our house in the vicinity of my mum, she'll probably try and sell you a book because she's probably my number one fan and salesperson as well. That being said, a quick segue into what we're talking about today, which is all about worry and a way of handling worry. I thought it was appropriate on Mother's Day because as mothers, as soon as you're a mother, so I hear, you just don't stop worrying really about your child, what they're doing, what they're up to, and I don't think it ever subsides no matter how old you get. So this tip might be especially important for the mothers out there, but I think it's useful for everyone. Because from time to time, we all worry. We have many things that we might worry about, whether that's the bills, whether that's what someone might say about us, whether our post is gonna do well on YouTube or Facebook, whatever else. So here is something I heard not that long ago, and I thought it was very simple, but yet genius at the same time. And that is to give yourself worry time. Worry time is earmarking a segment of your day, or maybe 5 minutes or so, nothing too long, where you are allowed to worry. You just spend that 5 minutes worrying about the thing, but then you agree not to worry about it at any other time during the day. So you just have your 5 minutes of worry, and that is that. And it reminds me of a quote that I heard once from the Dalai Lama, or read the Dalai Lama had said about worry. And it was this: if you've got something to worry about, and there's nothing you can do about it, why worry? If you've got something to worry about, and there's something you can do about it, why worry? You see, either way, you can do something about it, or you can't. But if you need to worry, allocate a small amount of time where you can worry, so it doesn't consume your entire day, but you still feel satisfied that you worried enough. Give yourself a whole 5 minutes to worry about that thing. Even write down what is the worst that can happen, because often when we write it down, it doesn't seem as real, it doesn't seem as intense as when it's in our head and we come up with all these permutations. So if you write down all the things that are worrying you, you spend that 5 minutes allowing yourself to be worried, you're free for the rest of the day. I hope that's helped you and served you in some way. This week, take that forward. Spend a bit of time each day. If you have anything to worry about, maybe you don't have anything to worry about, but if you do, allocate a minute, 2 minutes, 3 minutes, whatever it might be, where you're just gonna worry, and then you're gonna forget about it for the rest of the day. Let me know how you get on with that. I'm keen to hear what the results of this experiment are. If you haven't already, please subscribe. If you haven't subscribed, you're missing out, so do subscribe, and that way you will get my videos each and every week. You won't miss anything. Until next week, remember to do what you can to think, feel, and be superhuman. But more importantly for this week,
don't worry, be happy.
Bye-bye.
Don't worry, be happy. Don't worry, be happy. Ain't got no place to lay your head. Somebody came and took your bed. Don't worry, be happy. The landlord say your rent is late.